Hello everyone and welcome back. So in the last lecture we created our anime effects, and now we have our coin effects and anime spawning. You can see here there is one issue with our player movement. We cannot change our player direction. It just keep on moving and then just collide with the limits and then change the direction. So what we will do is, let's open our player script. And now what we want to do is, when we click on our screen, we want our player to change his direction. So here we will say, if input dot get mouse dot get mouse down 0, that means if we click on our screen, so what we'll do is, let's copy and paste here, it should be get mouse button down. Now here we will change our direction, so we will say moving right is equal to exclamatory mark moving right, and what this says is moving right value will be equal to opposite of moving right. So let's say if moving right is true, so what we will do is moving right will be set to opposite of true, which is false. And now we will set our direction is equal to negative direction. So what it does is, whatever is our direction, it just make it negative. That means if our direction is 1, it makes it minus 1, and if it's minus 1, then it makes it 1. And we will set our local transform. So let's copy this and paste it here. So now if you go back, so save your script and go back, and let's save the scene also. So let's click on play button, and you can see here, on clicking the mouse, our player changes his direction from left to right. So now we have our player movement complete. Now let's create some GUI. So just stop it and go to create, select UI, and let's select a canvas. Now just double click on canvas, and you can see this is our canvas. Our game is here. So what we will do is, select canvas, and here in render mode select screen space camera and drag camera to the rendering camera field, and here in sorting layer let's select GUI. And if you don't have GUI, then you can go to add sorting layer and just create one. And here UI scale mode is constant pixel, we don't want that. We want scale with screen size, and let's set it to 480 and 800 and match to 0.5. okay, so again double click. Now let's zoom. Now right click here, go to UI and create a new text, and we will name it score text, and let's select this icon here. Now holding shift and alt, select this here, and now let's change its height to 50. Let's see how it is looking, and let's position x to 10 and y to -10, or you can just drag it like this and just change the size. Now for alignment we will make it center, and here also center, and for best fit we will set it to true, and we will change value to 25. So let's set to extreme left here. Now this is our score. Right click and create a empty here, and let's again select this icon here, hold shift and control and select this one, And again, let's change its width and let's make it 150. And let's set it like this. And height to maybe 50 or 80. Let's rename it to coin holder, so it will hold our coin image and its text. Right click and create an image, and let's select this one again. Hold shift and control and select this. Change width to 45 and height to 45. And let's in the source image select this icon here and select our coin one texture or sprite. And let's again change width to 50 and 50. Okay, and let's move it to the left. Now we will change its name to coin image. Now select this coin holder, right click, create a text, select this icon, holding shift and control, make it extreme left, and let's resize it. Okay, and let's make it middle. And here we want to extreme right. We want best fit. Maybe increase our coin holder size by little and like this. Okay, let's make it 10, and let's change its color. So select this color picker. So in color, select this color picker and let's select this color here. Maybe a lighter one. Well, let's let it be black so it is visible. And again this one also black. Okay, and let's rename it to coin text. Now we have our score text and coin text, so right click and create a new script and name it menu manager. Now let's create a new empty, so create empty, reset, and name it menu manager, and let's drag the script to it. And now go to our editor. Now select reload solution and then go back and double click to open menu manager. Now we want reference to our text, so we will say private text and our score text, and you can see we are getting errors. So to use UI elements in the script, you need to import Unity Engine dot UI namespace. So now we have our text, and we will again have a coin text. So at the start we will set them coin text dot text to quotation plus 0, and our coin text dot text to quotation plus 0. Okay, and now we will create a public void increase coin method, and here we will update our coin text. So let's create a private int current coin and current score, and here we will say current coin plus plus, so we will increase it by 1, and we will set our coin text to our current coin, and we will just copy this method and we will paste it here, and we will say increase score, and we will increase our score by 1, and we will set our score text to current score. And now let's make it an instance. So public static menu manager instance, and we will call an awake method. So void awake, we will say if instance is equal to null, then instance is equal to this. So let's go back to our player script here, and here we are detecting our coin. So in this method we will say instead of debug.log, we will say menu manager dot instance dot increase coin. So we are calling our increase coin method here, and for score we will go to our enemy, and here our enemy is getting destroyed when it hits the ground. So we will call menu manager dot instance dot increase score method here. So if we go back, so we don't have our field, so let's go to script, let's go to menu manager and let's make it a serialized field, and go back to the editor. Now we are having our fields, so let's drag our coin text to coin text field and score text to score text field. So now if we press on play button, we can see our player is moving and our score is increasing, and we can see after collecting coin our coin is also increasing. So now let's select this canvas game object, right click and create an empty game object. Let's name it to game menu and select this here, holding alt and shift select this, so you can see all the blue nodes are on the extreme of our GUI. Now drag these two components here as a child, and we don't want it to be active at the start of our game. Let's create another empty and rename it to menu, and now we will create a UI button here, and let's select this menu and select this, holding alt and shift select this one. So we'll call this play button, and let's change its size, and let's change the text to play and best fit, let's make it 80. Okay, now let's add some title to our game. So select UI text, now select this, holding alt and shift select this, and now you can just name it your game. So title, and it will be falling enemies, make it an center and best fit, let's make it, let's say 150. Okay, so we have our title and we have our play button. Now let's create a game over. So again right click, create empty and name it game over. Now in game over we'll create a image, and this will be our panel, and we will resize it again, right click and create a text. I will say name it game over. Let's set it at the top, so shift alt and top. Now let's set it to center and best fit, let's make it 80, resize it, now this will be game over text. Now one more right click, create a text, and this will be our game over score text. Okay, so it will be score 25 by default, and let's set it to best fit, and let's change the size of this. Okay, and one more right click, duplicate, and this will be our coin text, and let's name it coin, and let's drag it down like this. Okay, and select panel, and let's add some outline. So select add component, and in this search box type outline. So we'll say outline here. Let's make it 3x3, and let's change it to red to show it's game over. Now again select panel, right click, and create a button, and this button will take us to home. So let's rename it to home button, and let's change it home and make it paste fit. Okay, so now let's deactivate this and activate our menu. So let's go back to our scripts, and here we want game over score text reference and game over coin text reference, and we also want a private game object, game menu reference, main menu reference, and game over menu reference, and we will make it a serialized field. Okay, so in player script we have start moving boolean, and it is right now only a getter, and we want to set it from our main menu manager. So let's call set, and start moving is equal to value, and let's go back to menu manager, and here we will create a new method. So public void play button, and we will say menu dot set active to false. So we want to deactivate our main menu, we want to activate our game menu. So say game menu dot set active to true, and we want our player. So let's call player dot instance dot start moving to true. So now let's go back to player, and we don't need this code here, so we can just delete this code. And in main menu and in menu manager we have our play button, so let's create a home button. So copy this, let's paste it here and rename it to home button, and we want to reload this level whenever we click on the home button. So we will call using Unity engine dot scene management. So we need scene management to take care of our scenes, so we can just say here scene manager dot load scene, and we will say scene manager dot get active scene dot name. Okay, now we want our game over also, so we will call public void game over method. I will say here game menu dot set active to false, our game over menu dot set active to true, and we will say game over score text to our current score, and our game over coin text to our current coin, and we want to call our text, so game over score text dot text and game over coin text dot text. So if you go back to our player, here we are checking just for our coins, so let's check for enemy also. So if other dot compare tag is enemy, that means we are colliding with enemy, we will call our game over. So menu manager dot instance dot game over, then okay, then we will deactivate the game object. So we will say game object dot set active to false. So let's go back and try. So select menu manager and let's fill these fields. So let's drag menu to menu, game menu to game menu, and game over menu to game over menu. Now we want game over text, so let's go back. So game over score text and game over coin text. Okay, so our fields are filled. Now let's add function to our buttons. So if we go to our main menu and play button, you can go down here and here on click, just click on this plus icon and drag our menu manager to this field, and in function select menu manager, play button, and same for our home button. So go to on click, select plus icon, drag menu manager and select home button. So let's try now. So if I click on play, you can see our game is not starting though our player is changing direction. Let's click on play and you can see our player starts moving. So let's make some score. Okay, our player died, so you can see we are showing our game over screen. But there is one more issue. Even after our game is over, our enemies are still spawning. So what we can do is, let's close this and go back to our, so let's go to our menu manager and here we will create a public field and we will say a public bool game over, and it will be false by default. And let's go down and in game over we will say game over is equal to true. In enemy spawner you can see here when we start our game we are spawning our wave. So what we can do is we can add one more if condition here, and that is and menu manager dot instance dot game over is equal to false. So this says that if our game is started and our game over is false, we can spawn our enemies. So let's go back to our editor. Now let's play. Let's click on play and you can see our player is moving. Let's make some score. Okay, so now our game is over and our enemies are no more spawning. So let's click on home button and we are reloading the scene. So click on play and you can see the game starts again. Thank you, and I will see you in the next lecture.